Right. So here I mentioned a little bit about my son and about his vision and what we were really working on with him. So the occupation mm-hmm. that he obviously needed to be able to do was to learn to read. And that's what was really mm-hmm. holding him back was his vision. The occupation mm-hmm. that he wanted to do, though, was to be able to play hockey. And this was huge for him to be able to.
Yeah.
I know. And mm-hmm. he actually just going to toot his little horn for a second, but he just tried out again a couple weeks ago and made our top team for our local league.
Yay!
So all of this
was <That's> exciting. Yes.
Yeah, so what was happening for him, I mentioned, was convergence disorder, visual scanning, problems with sensory processing. And mm-hmm. so we just used so much outside. Now, again, this was in addition to his therapy, where he was going mm-hmm. to vision therapy. But what we were doing was things like he would be bird watching. So he would look outside and even close by in our bird feeder. And then we would find it in a book right next to him. So he was looking mm-hmm. out and then looking down. We did a ton mm-hmm. of looking out and trying to find specific details. So what does the mm-hmm. beak look like? What does the eye, you know, what are the eyes look like? And then he would draw.
Mm.
So again, he's looking.
Oh, yes. So you're going up and then right down. Yeah. Okay. Very cool.
Tadpole catching, which that's what he's doing right there. But there he was standing left to right, which is the motor pattern that we were looking for. So he's all over the water that's down below. And mm-hmm. those little things are fast, right?
They are. Yes.
Very slowly. So he did a lot of that. Hiking with intentional questions. So I did a lot of I spy with my little eye, you know, looking out.
Oh, yes.
You know, in the woods when we're on our hike, or trying to find mm-hmm. some tiny little things that were nearby of what kind of flower is that? And do you, mm-hmm. have you ever seen that one before? So he's recalling and having to come up with a visual memory. All of these things that really targeted the exact same skills that he was working on in therapy. And so here's my little PSA as far as families who have their kids in therapy, which I think is absolutely fantastic. OT is obviously, I am an OT, but I think mm-hmm. occupational therapists have a huge role within our homeschooling community. But you should know what your children's goals are there. And there's so many people that mm-hmm. I talk to that I'm like, I don't know what she's working on in OT or,
really?
You know, I don't know what the OT is mm-hmm. setting the goals for. So they should be sharing with you. They should be part of your team mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. sharing with you what the goals are, and so that you can carry it over into your homeschool day,
yes.
into your outside, mm-hmm. into, you know, your life, because that's our point, is to help our kids to do what they want and they need to do. So if we are looking at it within our whole daily life, you have all the time in the world to be able to incorporate these things. Naturally.
Yeah. And I'm assuming, you know, when you're working with the therapist, you know, that they would know if you're asking them, well, what can we do outside to work on the same skills that you're working on? And they would have suggestions for, you know, uncreative people like me.
Yeah. Well, they should for sure. And they should mm-hmm. be able to say, you know, say some examples of other places or things mm-hmm. that you can carry over into different environments. If they can't, call me, because I'll help you. that's part of what I do, is help families to carry this over into, you know, carry over skills into their homeschool day. And I would love to help you with that.
That's awesome. Great. Yep. And we'll have your contact information up now. And actually, I can just put it up right here. It's homeschoolot.com. So, yeah.